Good evening, guys. So we'll start with the new chapter. What is this chapter? Chapter 5, right? Chapter name? Business cycle. Now improvement. From the first day, last day of economics. Good improvement. First day did not know topic. Forget topic. Subject name itself we didn't know. But today we know the chapter at least. Very good. Chapter name is business cycles. Now, you would have a brief idea of business cycle, I believe. Yes or no? No? You do not know how like economy is good, doing bad. That you know. First economy, you know what is economy? Some idea? Yeah? So, in TV channels, they'll say, no, India is doing well in GDP, blah, blah, blah. Nah, India is not growing, right? So, those things we are going to see. So, if they are talking about India, it shouldn't be macroeconomics or microeconomics? Micro or macro? It is macroeconomics because it's affecting all over India, correct? Yes or no? If that is the case, why are we studying it here in business economics? Because business economics incorporates some elements of macroeconomics also. Chapter 1, features of business economics, right? That is how you have to study on this. That is why we are studying under business. See, these things will affect your business also. Are we clear? That is what it is. Now, the first term which you have to understand is business or trade cycle. Business or trade cycle. Okay. Now, everything in run, everything has its own cycle. If you see, what is a cycle? Starts at one point and comes back. Circle. So, this is circle, not cycle. But cycle of life, they say, right? Starting, then that rebirth starting. So we see a continuous thing, we call it as a cycle. Okay. Business also, businesses, right, also go through a cycle. Okay. That is good phase for your understanding. Just for your understanding, there is a specific word for it, right? But we'll just understand it like this. Good times. Can we say, I'm having good time now? Then exam comes. Then it's struggling time. Right? Then results come. Bad time. Then scolding comes. Depression comes. Right? Then again you will get used to your friends will come cheer up. Then again good times. So this is how it is. For business also, they'll have good times, bad times, struggling times, as well as depression times. Okay. So there is always fluctuation in that business. Are we clear? There is always some fluctuation in how they work. So that in simple term is known as business cycle. Are we clear? So companies will have good times. Good times means what? Making more profit, making more revenue. Right? What is bad times? Company is making lesser profit or losses or, right? Selling less of it. That is bad times. Are we clear? In simple sense, what they are saying is business cycle means companies will go through this. Good times, bad times. Okay? In specific, we'll study what it is. Okay? Now, first we'll read this definition. These are rhythmic fluctuation in aggregate economic activity that an economy experiences over a period of time. Now, businesses have good time, bad time. India, right? Economy means India. Aggregate economic activity means what? Entire economic activity in India also experiences this good time, bad time fluctuation. Fluctuation. Are we clear? Rhythmic fluctuation. Good time, bad time, good time. Right? Some rhythm is there to it. right? Fluctuation is there. It's always good time? No. There is good time, bad time, then depression time, sad time, everything is there, no? Happiest time, right? It's your birthday means happiest time, right? All these things are there. Yes. So there is a rhythm, there is fluctuation in aggregate economic activity in all over India. All the businesses will have it, right? That an economy experiences over a period of time. That we call it as trade or business cycle. Are we clear? Any questions here? No questions. Good. Now, they have itself classified majorly into two types. What is a good trade characteristics? What is a bad trade characteristics? We'll see it. Good trade characteristic means prices are slightly increasing slowly. Prices are not drastically increasing. Don't take that. Slowly prices are increasing. That is a good sign. For example, if you add, I do not know whether you buy onions or potatoes and all, right? Or egg. Egg you'll definitely know. Before all, one egg used to cost you 1 rupee, 2 rupees. Now it's costing you 6 rupees. The prices are slowly increasing, right? Because economy is doing well and all those things. Normally, in a good economy, prices tend to increase slowly. Okay, if that happens, it's good for the economy. If it increases drastically, it's very bad. Okay, small element of inflation is good for every economy. Okay, done. Lower unemployment. Lower unemployment means what? What is unemployment? What is unemployment? Employed means what? I have work. Unemployed means I don't have work. Low unemployment, very less people are unemployed, not in employment. So everyone is working. High employment, I can say it is. Okay. So everyone is working. That is a good characteristic. What is a bad characteristic? There is fall in prices and high rate of unemployment. There is fall in prices and high rate of unemployment. That is a bad characteristic. Now, economic fluctuation is recurrent and occurs periodically. Right? What they are saying is, it will come and go, it will come and go and occur periodically. That is what they are saying. Okay? But, they are saying one more thing. But not always at regular intervals. But not always at regular intervals or of the same length. That means you might be happy for so many months. One day something will come and spoil your mood. Next day you'll be all right. Right? Similarly, an economy also might grow, 10 months. 1 month it will fall. It'll go into bad. Then again it'll go back to good. But you cannot specify the length also. Or you can't specify how much it will fall. Or it will always 10 months if it grows, it will come 1 month fall. You cannot say that also. It is unpredictable. Are we clear here? These are the important points which you have to say. Now, there are 4 to 5 parts depending upon how you want to say the business cycle. So we are going to narrate a story to understand this. Rather than studying in theory, if you narrate a story, it will be better. Otherwise, you will sleep off. Right? Story means you'll be like, bedtime story. You'll be awake. It's concepts and all, if I say, you'll be like, okay. Right? Now, we'll start with the story of this business cycle. Now, let's take India. Right? Let's take India. Or, in India, imagine there is one outside our academy. Okay. There is one tea shop. Okay. There is one tea shop. Cheta is there. We'll draw the cheta also. Okay. Is what is he selling? Tea. Coffee, tea and bunda. Okay. Everything he is selling. Done. Now, he is selling it. Right. Where would he buy? He'll buy from a raw materials from another vendor, right? From another vendor. And that guy, right, he's a big company. Let's assume he's a big, very big company. Why big? We'll put like this. He's that vendor. Okay, he is buying from this company. Now, certain employees from this company also. So he is buying goods and services from this goods, raw materials from this company. Because it's nearby only, certain employees also walk. Okay, certain employees also go and walk and buy, what is it, a tea or chai and take one. Even our students, no, ArivuPro students, there is that, our academy. Okay, home. Okay, our students also will, what is it, go and buy from the chitta shop. Now, good business for them. Pakka, full on good business for him. Now more demand is there. Lot of people are buying. What will he do? He will first employ one more person to help him. Yes or no? He'll appoint one guy, yeah, nah, just for cleaning purposes or something like that. Yes or no? Then he'll be like, if I sell this coffee a little bit, at 11 rupees or 12 rupees, I'll sell. I'll make more money. People like my coffee. I'll slightly increase my price, right? According to, he'll know what is the demand. He will know approximately because he's been into this business, no? He will know, okay, 500 coffees or tea is always ordered. I will buy raw materials for 500 teas and coffee also. The business is doing good. All good. So can we read this, what is happening here? Yes. We'll connect with this example and that. Right, increase in national output, right, employment and aggregate capital and consumer expenditure, sales, profit and rising stock prices and bank credit. Imagine this is happening for one shop. Imagine for the entire India. Lot of businesses are doing well. Here we are taking one shop as an example for you to understand it, right? Take all over India, there are lot of shops, lot of companies are there. Then so output is increasing. Output means tea is selling more, right? Employment is increasing. He's hiring one person. Aggregate demand, right? Consumer expenditure. I am also, students are going spending. What is it? The staffs are coming and spending. Everything is happening. Rise in stock pricing. Rise in stock prices. All things are happening. Good? Done. Involuntary unemployment is almost zero. What is involuntary unemployment? I want job. Okay, I want job. I will get a job in this market. If I want to work, I will get a job. Okay, if there are two type of unemployment, right? I am not working. I'm not interested to work also. That is also unemployment. I am interested to work, but I am not getting a job. Yes or no? So here what they are saying, I am interested to work, right? I am interested to work and I am not getting a job. That will be almost 0% is what they are saying. In the reality, it's not true, but okay. There can be like unemployment where I do not want to work enough times. There can be unemployment where I do not want to work. But involuntary, right? Involuntary unemployment is almost zero. But there'll be frictional or fractional unemployment. What is this? We'll see. Due to change in jobs or suspended work due to strikes or imperfect mobility of labor. That is from one state to another state. It is taking time to, what to say. In Karnataka, there is more demand for labor. Whereas in Tamil Nadu, there is no less demand. So people are not willing to work, move from Tamil Nadu to Karnataka. That is imperfect mobility of labor. Structural unemployment caused due to structural change in economy. Suddenly they introduce certain structures like demonetization they introduce or something like that. It will affect the structure of things. Because of those things and all, what to say? There is unemployment levels. Are we clear here? Due to job change. Like I don't want this job. I want looking for another job. That time, for that temporary purpose, you will not have a job. That can also be. That is all called as frictional unemployment. Are we clear? Now, prices and costs tend to rise faster. Yes, our tea shop is increasing faster. Now, tea shop is increasing cost means even this vendor will be like, "Anna, you are buying from me only, no? I'll also charge a little bit extra." Okay? Yes or no? Done. High standard of living, growth rates eventually slow down and reaches its peak. Now, here, he's selling properly. Yes or no? He's nicely selling coffee. He's also having a good life. Even students are having tea, nice high tea, hi-fi tea, good feeling. Even employees having tea. Everyone is having good time, right? Like this, you look into other stuff. Not only this, look into other stuff. Like this guy is buying tea from this corporate, right? This corporate is making profit. If this corporate is making profit, won't it give salary tea to these employees? So he will go and buy more tea, or he will go and buy, what do you say, furniture, TV. More money means you will do more spending, you know. That is what. So there is high level of living and nice growth. Are we clear here? Any doubts here till here? The state continues till there is full employment of resources and production is at maximum possible level using the available resources. So now it is at, imagine correctly, whatever raw materials he wants, he is giving. Coffee plants. From where this guy will get? From coffee plants only or tea plants only he will get. So now their agriculture land, they are almost whatever they are producing, they are giving to this corporate and this guy is giving to him. This is how it is happening. Right? See, and one more thing, if employees are getting more money, what happened? They'll spend more. Yes or no? You will go, or your, if your, what to say, from this employment, one student is studying at ArivuPro. His dad has got promotion. The student will be like, my dad got promotion. I will give you treat for coffee or tea. Right? More money spent. So it's good for him only. That is what it is. Are you clear till here? This, all these characteristics, what we saw, is called as expansion. All these characteristics, what we saw, is called as expansion in business cycle. This is the first one. Are we clear? Second peak. Now, top and highest point of business cycle. Top or highest point of business cycle is called as peak. I'll show it in your exam, in the chart, that time you'll understand. Now you leave it. Let's see, understand what is peak. The later stage of expansion. That is the last stage of expansion is called as peak. Okay, when I show you the diagram, you will understand that. Inputs are difficult to find because of high demand and input prices increases. So in this, I told you, no, correctly, now this cheta shop is buying all the raw materials from this corporate. This corporate is buying from agriculture land. So in the agriculture land, there is some limitation. Yes, sir. Can you keep on growing coffee or tea? There's some limitations. Now, demand is, excess is increasing. Suddenly, this is what? It is stopping. It's not enough. So, won't he increase the price? Yes or no? To meet the demand, now the raw material price will be increased. Yes or no? It'll be increased. Done. That is what he's trying to say. So, later stage, inputs are difficult to find. Right? Because a lot of people are demanding for it. Inputs are difficult to find. Higher demand so that input prices are increasing. Output prices also rapidly increase to increased cost of living, greater strain on fixed income earners. Now, see, if I am getting at 5 rupees, I can sell it at 7 rupees, 2 rupees profit. If I am getting at 7 rupees, what will I do? I'll sell it at 9 rupees. Yes or no? So what will our cheta guy will do? He will also increase the price. Yes or no? He will increase the price. Because he will also increase. Right? That is what is happening here. So if prices, see, this is 7 rupees item, 10 rupees item. So imagine big items. Just give an example of bigger items to yourself, right? Food, right? From food is getting expensive, or some other facility which you use, petrol, is getting expensive. This will affect you or not as a consumer. As a consumer, now instead of spending that 2 rupees, 3 rupees, you could have spent it something else for the same. Your purchasing power is getting down. All these affects. Yes or no? Are we clear on this? So there is some strain on these employees as well as students. Before they were getting at a cheaper price, tea. Now they have to pay more. They have to pay more. Okay. Now, consumer began to review their consumer expenditure on housing and durable goods. Now, consumer will review, okay, should I go for tea? Instead of, let's say I went normally every 1 hour, every break of economics, you used to go for a tea break. Now you will be like, okay, hey, it's a little bit costly, no? Why should I go every now and then? I'll go once. Yes or no? Won't you think like that if prices are increasing? That is what it is. So actual demand stagnates. Actual demand stagnates. This is the end of expansion. It occurs when economic growth has reached a point where it stabilizes for a short term, then moves in the reverse direction. Okay. So this actual demand. Now you are having two teas. Because price increases, you started having only one tea. Right? Now demand is going to stagnate. Or you're going to buy, demand is going to fall. Okay. When it's going to fall, that the point where it's going to fall, that point is called as peak. Okay. So to illustrate using a diagram, see this. See, economy is growing, expansion, demand is growing, productivity is happening, everything. This is called as expansion. Okay. This highest point you see here, no, is called as peak. That is what I said later. This is the later point, no, of expansion. Last stages of expansion is called as peak, highest point for that particular cycle, economic cycle. For that particular economic cycle is known as peak. Are we clear here? Till here, any doubts, please answer. Till here, any doubts? Okay. Now, producers continue anticipating higher demand, thereby supply far exceeds demand. Now, understand from the Cheta's angle. Yesterday, 500 people came for tea. Right? Normally, 500 people will come. I have increased the price. Right, I expect how many people to come today also? 500 people to come. Great. Will I know that because of price increase, you guys won't go? No, I might not know. Right? So what I will do, I will order for what? 500 teas inputs. I will order that. Yes or no? Okay. That is what I wanted to tell you. So now, supply is exceeding demand. Supply is exceeding demand. After producers aware overproduction, they respond by holding back the future investment plans, cancellation, stoppage of all types of inputs. Now, what happens? Cheta realizes, oh my God, no one is coming for buying my coffee. What will he say to this corporate? He'll say, sir, already I bought so many teas, kept no one is coming and buying. So I will stop buying from you for some time. I will stop, or I'll buy a little bit lesser from you. I'll buy lesser quantity or stop buying. Okay, that is what happens. Now, this shop, this corporate, no, immediately gets, oh my God, he's Cheta, our best customer, right? He is buying lesser, no? Yes or no? Now what he will go and say to the farmer? Farmer, please produce less. I don't want to buy this much. Okay. And he will say to one of these employees, he will say, hey employees, Cheta was there first buying. Now he's not buying a lot of tea from us. So we need to, what do you say, reduce your salary. Our profits are coming down. So we will reduce your salary. Or some people also might be fired. Okay, you have to think, don't think so silly or like this also. This is for just for an example. Think from a bigger perspective, right? Different goods, right? So what happens here? So lesser people might be there working in office because of firing and lesser income. Will they go and buy now tea? Lesser people are there, so still lesser people will go and buy, right? Because of firing, only less people will go and buy. And because of income reduce also, lesser people only will pay and buy. Are we clear? So further demand gets depleted. Yes or no? So again he will say to corporate, hey, stop that. No one is buying at all. Stop the contract. I do not want tea at all. I'll put hot water and give. Right? Something on that. That is what he will say. So we'll read through it now. Decrease in input pulls down the prices, income, wages, interest earners gradually decline, resulting in decrease in demand for the good. Right? Now, because of excess tea also, Cheta will be like, I'll reduce the prices, right? And income of the wages also, the corporate boys, he'll also reduce the prices, no? Wages are getting reduced. And Cheta had one boy, right? To help him, his wages also decline. Right? That is all will happen. Are we clear? Now producers lower the price in order to dispose the excess. Now T he wants to dispose excess, right? So he'll further reduce the price. Okay. See, when he reduces the price, cost is still there, right? So his profit is still reducing further. Consumers postpone their purchases, reduce their consumer spending, and aggregate demand falls. Okay, consumers will not buy now, they'll keep on posting. Okay, later we'll buy now. Wages are not proper, something like that. Right? Investments start declining and employment starts declining. Okay, if every company is growing, no, investors. See, will you invest in a growing company or declining company? Growing company. So, as an investor, will you invest in Cheta shop right now? No, it's declining. So, investment also will start stopping. Okay, the process of recession is complete and severe contraction in the contract activity pushes the economy in the face of depression. Okay, now the process of contraction, if it goes very severe, okay, it goes very severe, it is called as, now this falling down is called as contraction, expansion, contraction, this you know, but if it falls very badly, it falls very badly, we call it as depression. Okay. Now, one more thing you should also understand here is, can be another case also. During COVID, right, every shop was locked down. No people bought, so many people was affected. Then immediately what your mom and dad, we have to say, ma, we can't, spend on everything and all. All those things happen in real life also. Okay, that is why they were saying open it up. Right? Lockdown means an enjoying inside the class, house, nothing doing. Students are happy. No exams, nothing. Keep the lockdown always. But the cure is, deadlier than the disease, they said. Have you read this? Lockdown is deadly than the coronavirus, they would said. Because of this only. See, if no one is, let's say, every business is closed. For 20, 30 days, it's so many business got closed, right? Imagine what would have happened. No sales. So many people would have dependent on that. Right? So many people, right? No salary, payment cuts. Payment cuts means expenditure cuts. Expenditure cuts means a lot of people are again further. Yes or no? You also, a lot of people did not do admission during June exam. You were like, no sir, we did not have. Right? So that is how it affects in real life also. Okay? Now, that is why they started opening up the economy. If they had not opened it, let's say, imagine they would have, they closed it till today. right? From 1 year, if they had closed it, what would happen? Imagine. You wouldn't have bought anything. You wouldn't have bought, studied. Nothing. No productive activity would have happened. Everyone will go for a toss, right? That is what it is. All these are real aspects of it. So you should understand. Now, trough and depression. Okay? Trough and depression. Now, depression is a severe form of recession, and it's characteristic by extreme sluggish economic activity. Depression is a severe form of recession. Okay? So, there is something called contraction, right? Contraction, we can say it as recession also. Okay? The economy is in the recession, they will say. Contract, another term is recession. And if it goes in an extreme form, we call it as a depression. Okay? Now, growth rates become negative. The level of national income and expenditure declines. Now, what to say? If Cheta was selling from, let's say, every month he used to sell 10 T's extra. Now he's starting to decline. Every month he's selling lesser and less T's, right? So that is growth rate becomes negative. Demand for the product and services and the price at the lowest and decline rapidly to shut down several production functions. So there are a lot of, not only this Cheta guy, there will be a lot of Cheta shops, tea shops. Right, certain shops will close down. A typical feature of depression is then fall in interest rate. Okay, one of the most typical feature of depression is fall in interest rate. Right, a depth of depression, all economic touches the bottom and the face is called as trough. So at the bottom, like peak is the last stage of expansion, right? So trough or depression is the last stage of contraction. Are we clear here? Now certain shops are getting closed, right? What will look, what happened to our tea shop nearby, right? Because now it reaches a low level of economic activity called trough and starts to recover. Okay, this is reversal process. Okay, that is the process of reversal is initially felt in the labor force. Producers anticipate lower cost and better business environment. A time comes when a business confidence take off, consequently they start to invest again and build stock over. The banking system starts expanding credit, technology advancement into two, blah, blah, blah. Employment increase, agriculture picks up, prices gradually rise. Okay, all these things there. We'll say it in our story format now. Okay, now, there I told you, other tea business starts to shut down. It'll start to shut down. That is called as trough. Now, our Cheta will be like the only survivor. Right? So, some people were going for this tea shop also. Now they started coming for this tea shop because there was no tea shop there, right? Now slowly Cheta would have ordered only 100 teas. Instead, first he was selling 500 teas, now he's selling 100. Suddenly, he was meeting 100. So constantly he was meeting 100, every month he was meeting. And slowly, 100 is hitting. Constant, it's not falling anymore. It's hitting 100 per. Business is stagnating now. Right? So then, slowly, it'll take time. Then 100 will become 101, 102, 110. Slowly, the business will again start to increase. If it starts to increase, what it'll say? He'll order more. He'll order more from the corporate. Corporate will say, give me more. Again, the recovery starts. So, if recovery starts, they'll hire more people, right? All wages will increase, all these things will happen. Now, business is going, investments also will come. Are we clear here? So, investment rises, production increases, employment improves, and consumer behavior increases in the expenditure.
Increased spending causes increased demand, aggregate demand, in order to fulfill the demand more goods, right? Employment, labor, unemployment falls, expansion takes place, and economic activity takes place. Are we clear on this? So, in sense, what to say? Economy expands, peak, contraction, or recession, or it goes, sometimes it goes to depression, right? Then trough. Then expansion, peak, contraction, trough, expansion, peak, contraction, trough. Over a period of time, if you see this, if it's tilted up, the trend is growing. Okay, this is called as a trend. Okay, so expansion is also called as boom or upswing, right? Contraction is also called as downswing or recession. Okay, trough or expansion. This is the stages of, four stages of business cycle. Are we clear with this concept?
Sir, in statistics, it's told that business cycle is 10 years. Sir. Is it so? In statistics, it's told that business cycle is 10 years. Now, which one are you talking about? I don't think so. For example, they would have given 10 years. Not that it's a real thing. Look into it. Huh? Which one? Insert, it's an example which was given in your book. Okay, that's the example. It's not necessary to be this thing. Okay.
Okay, any doubts, guys? Online? Alright. Now we will move to indicators. What is the indicator? Huh? Which indicates? Huh? Tell me. What will happen? Indicator. Huh? We turn the right indicator on. We put the left hand here. Go straight. That is the indicator. Correct? What is the indicator? Indicator means it is indicating that I am going to do some course of action. Okay. There are certain elements which will indicate the economic cycle. That is, if let's say for you, normally you are a smiling person, right? You'll always you'll be having a smile on your face. That means you are happy, right? If you're like this, very sad, or your face is not very happy, eventually you'll understand you are not in happy mood, you are in some mood, correct? That is an indicator, correct? Similarly, for an economy also, right, there are certain indicators to predict the economy, where is it going towards. Okay, activities to measure the business cycle. Activities to measure business cycle and to predict where the economy is headed towards are called as indicators. Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock. Are we clear here? Now, there are three types of indicators. One is leading indicator, two is lagging indicator, three is coincident indicator. Okay? Three types of indicators. We'll see what is what. Leading indicator. Leading indicator means, right, it is indicating before something takes place. Taking is an indication before something takes place. For example, for you to understand, because these are terms which are of a little bit higher nature, I'm just breaking down in a very childish manner. Right? Before it rains, what will happen? Clouds will be dark, right? Wind will be a little bit nice, breeze you will get, smell will be there, right? All these are leading indicators for rain. Similarly, for before the aggregate economy gets affected, variables which change before the real one comes, we call it as leading indicators. Variable that change before the real output changes are known as leading indicators. Let's see what are the changes. So exam questions will be asked, which of the following is a leading indicator, which of the following is not a leading indicator. Okay, But one thing is, certain things overlap actually. You cannot say this is a leading indicator actually. Okay, this is a lagging indicator. Very few can be said like that. Okay, but it's very tough also. You will not know whether which is leading, which is lagging. But anyway, changes in prices, profit margins, index, indices, interest rate, prices are precursors to ups and downturns. Okay, they change before the things happen. Are we clear here? That is one thing. If prices are increasing, no, you know, okay, why are the prices increasing rapidly? Something is going to change. That is a leading indicator. Okay, lagging indicator. Lagging indicator means, what is it? The rain example itself will take. How you know it rained here? Tell me. Water would have been there, no? Then only you know, huh, it rained. If you suddenly come later, you will say, huh, it's rained because water is there. That is lagging indicator. That is variables that change after the real output changes. That variables that change after, what do you say, the real output changes. For example, unemployment rate, corporate profit, labor cost, interest rate. See, if you see interest rate everywhere is there. Okay. So that is why I'm saying certain things you cannot say where it will fall. Price index, commercial lending activities, all those things. So leading indicator is a sign of onset of business cycle. Like lagging indicators confirm these trends. Right? So onset means before something starts. Right? Right? That is called as the onset. I welcome. They will say, before I start, I welcome everyone to your today's function or something. So they use the word onset, right? The onset of business cycle, before business cycle comes, change happens, leading indicators comes. Lagging indicators confirm the trends. That is, it's like, this is what it is. It is, economy is expanding. Lagging indicators confirm that. Coincident in economic indicators. Coincident means which happen along with the change. Which happen along with the change. Or co-current indicators. Another name is. Variable coincide or occurs simultaneously with business cycle movements. Right? Example, GDP. Industrial production, inflation, personal income, retail, sales, financial market, stock market prices. All are coincident indicators. Are we clear here? Now, some features of business cycle. What are the features of, characteristics of business cycle is what we are going to see the next topic. Occurs periodically. That is, happens periodically. Right? Intensity of fluctuation also varies. Intensity means economy can go up drastically, then come down a little bit and again go up. Right? This is also a peak. This is also a contraction. Right? So, intensity. How much it will fall, how much it will increase, no one can know. Intensity varies. But it will go up, down, for sure. That is for sure. Right? You have distinct phases, that is expansion, peak, contraction, trough. Generally originates in free market economy. What is free market economy? Forgot. Command economy or capitalism? Which one? Command economy or capitalist economy? What is called as a free market economy? Capitalist economy. First chapter. Go in the. Done. Free market economy means capitalist economy. What is capitalist economy? Where demand and supply interact each other and price mechanism, did we learn? No. Takes over. Okay. So that is what they are saying. So it only generally originates. Generally. It's not that it will not originate in command economy, but it generally originates in free market economy. Although all sectors are adversely affected by business cycle, industrial sector are prone to trade cycles. Industrial sector means, what to say, raw materials,
which are manufacturing, not service industry, manufacturing industry. Okay, they are affected by trade cycles because they are raw materials for something, right? If demand gets affected, immediately raw material only gets affected. Okay, manufacturing items get affected. That is why they are saying this. Complex phenomena and difficult to, concept is a bit complex, right? And it's difficult to predict is what they are saying. Repercussions get simultaneously felt in on all the economic variables. Repercussions means, you know what it is? Side effects. The effects gets affected for everyone. Okay? Gets simultaneously felt on all other variables. That is, it not only affects output. See, there is, let's say, something happens. One day, the Cheta's shop, right? Flame happened, right? One day output is getting affected. Yes or no? Is the employment getting affected? No. One day output got affected. But in trade cycle, output get affected, employment gets affected, interest rate, trade prices, everything gets affected. Okay? Repercussions is simultaneously felt in all the activities. Contagious and international in characteristics. See, is India independent of the world? No, India is dependent on many countries. Right, you sell and buy goods from outside India, right? If that is the case, if some economy is affected, even India gets affected. So if US economy and all heavily invest in India, if US is having a problem, they will not invest in India, right? Then India will also get affected. Are we clear here? Just for your understanding. Serious consequences on the well-being of society, right? Now India is growing good, so you have no problem. Imagine if India is not growing at all, and the serious consequences, right? If you want to understand the serious consequences, you should go back to your pre-independence. That time and all, what is it? Only few people had money, right? Everyone was starving. A lot of people were not having this. Now only everyone is having phone, right? Before, 40 years, was it the same economic status? Right, people were having, hey, I'm bigger person than you, you can't come and talk to me, all those things were there, right? As well as basic necessities, food, clothing and all, lot of people did not have. Everyone lived in huts. Now only people are having, moving to their own houses, buying cars, having a nice life, right? Before all, it was a... So, if economy is going very bad, all these things will repeat again, right? So you should, that is why you have to pay very important to know whether economy is going good or not, right? If it doesn't go good, you'll, at the end of the day, it'll affect you, right? That is one thing. Yes. What are the causes of, causes of this business cycle, we'll see. What are the causes of this business cycle? Internal causes. There are two type of causes. One is internal causes, one is external causes. We'll see what it is. Fluctuation in effective demand, right? Increase in aggregate effective demand causes expansion and boom, or decreases causes recession and depression. That is, effective demand gets changed. Fluctuation, yes, there can be a pause. Sometimes you want to buy, sometimes you do not want to buy. Alright, so there is affecting the effective demand, so there is fluctuation, so that affects the economic cycle. That is one. Fluctuation in the investment. If more investments are coming, more people will spend and all those things. If lesser investments are coming, you will spend lesser on things. That is what it is. Right? Investments considered most volatile component of aggregate demand. Increase most volatile component. Just know this. MCQ can come. This keywords, these kind of things only they can choose. Okay. Increase in investment shifts the aggregate demand to right. Right? And leading to economic expansion. Decrease will have an opposite effect. Are you clear? Variation in government spending. See, if government is spending more, then more people are going to get employed. Roads and bridges and all, if they build. Or vaccine, if they are going to give everyone, spending. More spending means what? More people are going to be employed, more inputs are going to be bought and manufactured. So, it'll be good for the economy. If they spend less, lesser people get benefit of it. So they also affect the economy. Are we clear?
Macroeconomic policies. What is macroeconomic policies? There are two types of policy: monetary policy and fiscal policy.
Monetary policy is policy made by the RBI.
Monetary policy is the policy made by RBI. Fiscal policy are policies made by the government of India.
What is monetary policy? Anything to do with financial products, interest rate, money circulation in India, right? All these things majorly take as interest rate, because that is the only thing you will understand for now. Are we clear? Is how much banks are giving you interest rate? Yes or no? They're saying 6%, 4%. Who decides that? Is the bank deciding? The RBI says minimum you have to give them at this interest rate, or maximum you can take this much interest rate. Or you would have studied also, this you would have studied, minimum liquid assets you have to keep, every bank should keep, right? Or cash, they should keep this much percentage, right? If they change that, won't banks have more money to spend more, give more loans, right? Or criterias. Does bank give everyone loan? They give only certain people loan based on certain criterias. RBI determines what are the criterias. Not fully determines, they give a policy framework. Okay, if RBI says give loan to everyone, then banks will be like, oh, huh, give loans to everyone. Okay, so certain things are done by RBI.
Certain policies are framed by government of India.
For example, right, income tax, GST, all these are again money related aspects only, right? But this is to the consumer, right? So here, those kind of policies where government affects your financial aspects, that is called as fiscal policy. Are we clear here? So income, if I increase income tax, what will happen? You'll have lesser income to spend, right? Right, if I reduce GST, then you can still, let's say, now we are paying how much? 1000 rupees, if I have to sell 18% GST. Right, 18% is how much? Almost 200 or 180 rupees will come. So 1000 rupees product, if you buy 18% GST, 200 rupees government takes. If they reduce it to 5% means how much? 5% means 50 rupees. Okay, so you will, that 150 rupees you are saving, you can spend on something else. That is how it is, right?
Expansion, okay, this is blah, 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 blah. So anything to do with banks and all those things, monetary, financial products, RBI takes over.
Anything to do with the finance aspect of consumer, the people of India and all income statement, all will come to
government, fiscal policy. Money supply. Money supply. Now, money supply will take, right, one day, one news happened, 8 o'clock, Mitron, right, Nam Desh, hey, 500 rupees gone, hey, yes or no?
Then what happened? You were like, oh my God, all my black money, huh? What were you guys doing on that? So money supply, let's come back to that. So in demonetization, what happened? Money supply reduced. Money supply is the money circulating in the economy. They said 500 notes and 100 rupees notes, 1000 rupees notes. 500 and 1000 rupees notes are banned, right? Money supply reduced. So were you able to exchange for that 500 rupees? No, that 500 rupees was worthless now, right? Because of money, notes are not there, you were not able to buy certain products that time, remember? Your mom, no change ma, you give something else, they would have sent. Paytm, Karo, that group, all those things, right? So because of money supply being less, it affected the business economy. right? Sometimes they would have asked you cash, you would be like, I don't have change. No change. Okay, I'll buy later. Yes or no? Sometimes you would have said that. No, that is what will happen. Unplanned changes in supply of money may cause business fluctuation in economy. Increase in supply of money causes expansion in aggregate demand in economic activities. On the other hand, decrease in supply of money reverses the process and initiates the, what is it, recession. So if people have more money, they'll spend more. People have lesser money, supply is less in the economy, they'll spend lesser. That is what it is. Okay, so that is why if the during COVID times, no, money was, supply was coming less, so they distributed free, the loan category was a little bit reduced. Yes or no? Government gave certain loans to businesses. You take, you run. That was a good initiative, right? Last one is psychological factors. Sometimes businessman will think, now take a scenario now. Will you start a new business? Sometimes you might think, corona, all is going again. Second wave they are saying, third wave they are saying, what all they are saying. Yes or no? You will think, should I start business or not? Should I invest or not? That also affects the, business cycles. Okay, if group of people are saying, lot of people are saying, it's not going to grow. Then what will happen? Businesses will not grow. That is why, if you see stock markets and all, it's a sentiment. Psychological factors are heavy. Lot of people are saying, Reliance will not grow means, Reliance share will fall. Lot of people think Reliance will grow means share price will increase. That's all. It's all sentiments at the end of the day. Okay? That is an important rule. External causes of business cycle. Now, let's say another country, okay, will come and say, war. What will happen? Already in the border and all, tension is there. Correct? If they go, let's go for a war. You're like, what? Mara? What will government do? Can it prioritize on infrastructure? No, it'll concentrate on how to win the war. It'll say, it'll make more guns. It'll make more, soldiers. It'll train more soldiers. So the intention will go towards a different activity, which will affect, the businesses. That is one. Post-war reconstruction. Once the war is over, right? External funds will come, even the a country will spend some time, right, to restructure what happened, to recover the damages. That is that, right? Technological shocks. Growing technology enables the production of raw materials and better services. This leads to expansion of employment, income and profit. Now, if technologies are growing, new technologies happen, new opportunities can be derived. If a new technology happens, opportunities will be denied also. For example, in your PUC and all, how did you do your accounts? Your accounts. How do you think accounts is done in companies? You think they'll open a book, they'll draw on that code, right? Ledger folder, LF, 3, cash to bank, being, cash transfer to bank. That and all they'll do, you think? No? Then how do they do accounting? There are softwares for it. Okay, there are softwares for it. You just pass, it'll automatically, everything is from, you just pass the journal entry. Okay, or certain other invoice raising or something you have to say. Right? You do that, automatically ledger is created, everything is done, balance sheet is done, everything is done. On that immediately. Okay, that is how real life accounting takes place. So imagine your method of doing it. 100 people buy, you will write. 100 people bought. What is your name? Ram account debit to something sales. Then pre account debit. Imagine how much you have to time waste. Right? Or opening Ram account ledger. You have to open one Ram. How much efforts is required here? Right, more labor is that time was required for doing this accounting. But now, one system is there, right? Immediately you do, tuck. Now you require less labor or more labor? Less labor. In the future, computer might substitute that also. I know Ram, he purchased. I'll pass journal entry. Why you want a human being? So technological shock. If a new technology comes, it might affect the old technology also. Okay, like for example, Jio came. Right, 4G, Dandatanaka offer, full, free. Take it, ma. Take it, macha. Enjoy. Right? You enjoyed fully Jio? Free? I enjoy. Okay. So, what happened to other companies? Their businesses got affected. Right? Technological shock. That is also. External forces, basically. Natural factors, like COVID comes. It's all natural factors, which affects businesses. Tsunami comes. Earthquake comes. Everything comes. So, it will affect the businesses. Population growth, right? If population is growing, then more people will buy. If lesser population, lesser. It depends how, what product you are saying, right? Certain, higher population is good for certain things. Lower population is good for some things, right? It depends on this. The growth rate of population is higher than the rate of growth economy. There will be a lesser saving economy. Fewer saving means lesser investment. There will be slowdown in the economic activity. Done. Relevance of business cycle and business decision making. Why should we study this as managers? Because you should not only know your consumer preferences or consumer surpluses or production function, cost function, right? You should know what is happening outside also. That is what it is. Because understanding the business cycles help the business to anticipate and get prepared. See, if you are not focusing on business cycles, then you will, what do you say? You will not know what is happening outside. You will sell the wrong product. You will price the product wrongly. You will not make profit. So that is why it is important, right? Because affects the demand for the product, and in turn, business cycle affect the demand for the product. In turn, the profit, which ultimately determines the business is successful or not. Businesses whose are closely linked to the rate of economic growth are referred to cyclical business. So businesses which are very close to, what to say, business cycle. If business, if economy is going, this business also grows. If economy is coming down, this business also comes down. We call it as cyclical businesses. These are the examples of it. Are we clear? Chapter done, done or done. Okay. So, we will be practicing some MCQs as usual in the next video. Okay. For now, take a break.